So, Printful.com has these amazing high-waisted yoga leggings. They are all over print. All you do is upload your design file, and they do an incredible job of printing your design on leggings. And the lineup is so great. They line up the seams really, really well. Everyone should be making rad leggings with Printful. So, I'm going to teach you how. So, here we have this little video in the middle of me wearing my latest design, which is like 80s gym shorts with thigh-high socks and then some skin tone legging in the middle. These are leggings. That's not my legs showing. Those are the actual Printful leggings. Here's a picture that I took of myself wearing those leggings. Here's a different picture of another pair of Printful leggings I made. These are supposed to look like Wonder Woman. Obviously, you can't sell Wonder Woman leggings. That's a copyright violation. I don't even sell these, but I wanted them for myself, so I made them. Here's some others. These are my witchy leggings. I love these. I have a picture of these on somewhere. Here we go. So check out how vibrant the print is on the witchy leggings. They are awesome. I'll do a different video with a review of the actual leggings and you can see them all on. But you can see that the design translates really, really well from the mock-up to the actual leggings. Here is another pair. This was the first, I think this pair with the tattoo stars was the first illusion leggings I created. I thought I had a picture of myself wearing these. Here it is. So, this is me from the front wearing these illusion leggings. Obviously, you might not get an exact skin tone match, but these are close enough that they trick people. People think I'm walking around my nice suburban neighborhood in booty shorts all the time. I'm not, and I have these fake tattoos going down the back. So, I'm gonna walk you through how do you actually start to create these costume type illusion leggings. And I'm gonna show you what my process was the first time I ever made these. So, first step obviously is to download the Printful design files. So, for your yoga leggings, you're gonna end up with a waistband template for the front and back. But the more important one is the actual legs template. So, I love Printful's website. It's so easy to use, and these design files are really, really nice. If you open the one that works in your system, whatever design program you use, I'm using Affinity Designer. You can see here, I love Affinity. I could not be happier with it. This gives me an overlay which has openings where I can see what is actually going to show up on the design, the actual fabric, and what will be included in the actual design versus what is a bleed area right here. And so this is how I started. When I had this idea to create costume leggings, the first thing I had to do was to figure out where on the legs in this template do different parts of the body hit. So what I did, I'm gonna hide my guide layer. All I did was I created a series of rectangles in different colors. And this is where Printful's mockup generator becomes really, really helpful. So I created a series of rectangles. I'm going to put them behind the guide. Here we go. And I just kind of guessed where I thought different things would be. So I'm going to copy and paste a second rectangle. I'm going to make it a different color. And I'm going to bump it up to just get an idea. Because when we upload this in the mockup generator, it's going to give us a really nice guide of where different things are. And so I think this area down here, I'm just gonna kind of eyeball it. And I think I'm going here to here. I'm thinking this might hit knees, but I'm not sure because remember, I'm pretending this is my first time doing this. I'm gonna go up again with another rectangle to up to the bottom of the triangle here. This triangle is the crotch piece. So whatever piece your shorts, whatever color your shorts are, if you're doing an illusion legging, you want this triangle to match that shorts color. Red, orange, yellow. We'll go to green. Now I'm gonna go right to this connecting, this piece right here where it connects, I think, in the crotch. And I'm gonna make another rectangle. We're gonna bump it blue. I'm gonna go right up to the top. And so, giving myself a little guide to see where I think things are was my first step towards figuring out placement. and how I was going to be able to draw the lines for different sections of my design. So now I'm going to hide the guide, and all I'm going to do is export this. Printful prefers PNG or JPEG. So here we are. I'm going to add a pair of all-over print yoga leggings to my store. And the whole purpose of this is to just get a little guideline for myself for when I'm designing to see where these different lines hit on the body. And excuse me. And then that's going to help me figure out how to make my final design. So my design uploaded. I'm placing it here. They're not going to show you a mock-up until you choose your stitch color and with or without pocket. But now I can get a mock-up view, and this becomes my guideline for creating kick-ass designs. So obviously we didn't upload a waistband, but check this out. Now I'm going to copy this image and I'm going to paste it into my design program. So now what I have is a visual guideline of where things start and end in terms of where I want my design to be. So let's say I want to do a fake pair of shorts. If I want really short shorts, this blue rectangle is in a great place for it. So I actually also discovered when I was designing, but you should, your mileage might vary. You might want to do a little. If I drop it a little, if I drop this top layer a little bit below, so now I'm going to take those guide boxes that I originally created and I'm going to hide them. And they're just there for line as lines for me. So now I can always look. And if I want something to hit right, you can see where I have this orange and yellow border that's right in the middle of the knee. So now I can eyeball. If I want knee-high socks, I can pull up a box to right about there and then start designing. So if I want short shorts, this blue is right about where I want it. I did learn to pull it down just a little so when the crotch area is sewn together, you won't have any empty space or any leg. You don't want any like flesh color in the middle of someone's crotch or their leggings. So I pull that down a little. But of course, I don't want short shorts that go straight across. So I'm going to turn this into a curve. And then I'm going to change the angles a little. So I'm going to put a node right there to keep this level here. But I want where these, do you see where these come out in the edges? I want this to be covered in short area and not flesh. Because this is the seam, if you look, this is the back seam that comes right into the middle, the triangle part of the crotch area. And I don't want any flesh in that area, so I'm just pulling this shape down a little bit to go a little past there. But I also want my shorts to be kind of cheeky, so I'm gonna just pull them up like that. And if I want it to be really specific, I could actually create just half of, like, I could cut this in half and then duplicate. But what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to copy the curve and paste it. I'm being a little bit lazy. I'm going to color it black, but I'm going to pull down and then I'm going to flip it. Ooh, look at it. Do you guys see how symmetrical? That's pretty awesome if you think about it. So what I'm looking for is symmetry. So I can see this blue curve. Wherever I see blue curve here is a little bit of asymmetry in my design. So I'm just pulling it up. Why is this? I didn't want to select it for some reason. So now I'm just pulling it up and I'm adding a node there so I don't lose the symmetry. I can delete that curve that I copied. Now I have a pair of shorts. This should be, I'm hoping this will be shorts that kind of come up here instead of straight across. I want them to come up to look more like booty shorts. And since this is just a simple curve, I can also add, let's say I wanted white piping around it. I can just add a white stroke, and there you go. So now our design needs some legs. So I'm going to take my original rectangle since I just already had it. And I'm going to drop some leg color here. Oh, I probably stroked it. I'm going to drop it. So what we have right here, this file should look like a basic pair of booty shorts with this like kind of peachy white person leg color skin tone. So I'm going to do, again, I'm going to turn off the grid. And you, no, I'm not going to do that because remember this triangle? That has to be blue or else you're going to have a flesh-toned crotch, which is going to be a little bit creepy. So all I'm doing is putting a triangle there and I'm coloring it. Where are my swatches? Blue. So now we go back to the mock-up generator. So I like to, I'm also saving constantly. The worst thing ever is to lose your work because you didn't save it. I'm going to export this as a PNG. All right, so I've placed my new leggings design, and now I'm going to check out this mock-up view. And the mock-up tool, I cannot stress how amazing it is because, look, it shows you. Look at that. That looks pretty nice. I think I want them a little bit higher if I were making this a pair of shorts. But already, you have a pair of shorts on flesh skin. This alone would be enough to be a great pair of leggings if you just wanted some quirky leggings to wear. Obviously, you want to try to match your own skin tone, or if you're selling these, you'll want to match your customer's skin tone. My advice would be to offer a palette of skin tones, just a drop down, and then just pre-design everything in Printful so people, it just gets pushed through immediately. But if you want to customize from a picture, you can always just do a color drop and customize people's skin tone. But we went from this to this with some very, very simple designs. And this is all, this is it. This is what your file is going to look like. Super, super simple. Now, if I decide I don't like the curve, I added this extra node, which is a problem now. Because if I want to increase the curve, that node would pull, it wouldn't be consistent. So let's say I want this higher. I'm just pulling this curve up a little bit if I want these shorts to go up more. And so this is where your design skills come in. You can start really tweaking it. You can start to add your own situation. Now, if I wanted knee socks, I can go back to my guides. And remember, my orange, I'm going to copy and paste my orange because that box was right in the middle of the knees. Now, I don't want knee socks coming all the way up to the knees, so I'm going to pull them up to here. And let's say I want white knee socks. I'm going to make them white. But I want to go old school. I'm an 80s kid. We're going to make some like 80s style knee socks. So all I'm doing is adding a thin rectangle. Let me get rid of this guide here so you can just see the boxes. So these will be our knee socks. I'm adding a thin rectangle, and we're going to go navy. I'm adding a second one. I want to do two stripes with a red in between. And I'm using Affinity has snapping guides, so it'll just automatically tell me when I'm right in the center. And so here with just simple little rectangles, I added what I think is going to look like some knee socks at the very bottom of my leggings. And I could go again and upload a new file to the mockup generator, which is exactly what I'm going to do. All right, so I'm placing this new file I created, and let's go to the mockup and see what we think. Look at this. I love it. So I'm really picky. I'm probably going to want to stare at it for a little while if this were something I was going to actually create. I'm going to copy it again. I like pulling all the mockups into whatever program I'm working with to design so I can really look at them. So you can do anything you want. The same way we manipulated the shorts here, you could manipulate the socks. If you want them to be up a little higher on the outside, lower on the inside. Another thing to think about is these shorts are not going to cover the butt of the actual wearer very much. So they're really symmetrical, so they're going to be covering... it's going to be about that in the back. And I'm going to open another leggings design to show you what I'm talking about in terms of butt coverage. So let's get these instructions. So remember, this is the back of your leggings. And so depending on what you're looking for, maybe you want like a really cheeky pair of shorts or maybe not. These are my other, so I have Wonder Woman, those Wonder Woman leggings. This is the actual design file from the Wonder Woman leggings that I made. And then this is one that I changed the, I really played with the lines to make it look like an old school leotard. And that worked. It took a lot of trial and error. And then this is those, these are those tattoo leggings I have. So you can see they actually do come, the border comes straight to that tip. So is that what my demo, so my demo's doing that. These should be okay. Actually, I'm wondering now if the mock-up generator shows the back. I'd love to see the back. I feel like this is a new thing. I don't remember. Ooh, here we go. Check that out. So there you go. That's enough back coverage for me if I'm going to wear it, but you have to decide for yourself. So here we are. This is the most basic, simplest way to get started creating illusion leggings. Now, my next tip is to add some texture. I mean, obviously, stitching along the piping on your shorts would be awesome, and you can do a stitching really, really easily. If you're working in a design program, you can just copy and paste the curve that you're using for your shorts, create a stroke. I'm gonna pull that blue color from my swatches. This is so small, it's hard for me to see anything. And then what I'm gonna do here is I'm going to make it a little bit darker. You can see that. And then I'm going to make a dash stroke if I want to mimic some stitching. So I don't know how you do that in other design programs, but here in Affinity, I would just do it like this. And I want it to be maybe right on that edge. And maybe instead of blue, I'm going to do a gray situation. I don't know. I'd have to think about the stitching, but that's just an easy way to add a little bit of texture into your design. So here, these are different files I used for my old school gym shorts. So this is the file for those gym shorts that I showed you in the beginning. And here are the socks. I love these 80s socks, but as you can see, I created a little, this looks like a knit pattern. I'm sure if you use like free vectors online, there's so many databases, you can find a knitted vector pattern. So I just created my own because it's easier, and then I copied and pasted it a million times for it to be large enough for the file. But I take this overlay, I made it a really light gray color, and I just put it over the entire section of socks that are going to be on the cut fabric for my final. And then at the top, I just did a tall fabric kind of stitch knit situation. And that turned out really, really nice. Now, these are gym shorts, so they're more complicated. You can see that I have additional shapes. And this took a lot of trial and error with the mock-up generator, but it's nothing that nobody could do pretty easily. I have all these pictures. I have all these reference photos that I work from. I got color palettes from there. This is a pair of these are my 80s gym shorts with just knee-high socks from the mock-up. And then here's the final file I used for those tattooed legs. Oh, something I should tell you too is, if you can see, these are the stars that go down the calves on the tattooed legs leggings, and I squashed them. So they're supposed to be a little bit wider, or the star would originally be wider. I squashed them so when they stretch over my legs, they won't look stretched out widthwise. I wanted them to look like regular stars, and they will stretch a little bit. Thanks. So hopefully you guys go out, you start creating awesome stuff, and when you start selling it, please drop your link in the comments. I want to see what you're creating. Have fun, and check out, please subscribe, like my videos, and I'll be posting more reviews and tutorials with Printful if this one does well. Bye-bye.